Looking to transmute some unwanted cards into a booster box? Look no further than ChannelFireball.com's online buy list. We offer competitive prices on cards from Ancestral Recall to Zombie Master, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you're not looking for cash, we offer a 30% store credit bonus. Head to ChannelFireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order. It's faster and easier than winning with a pack rat.
Hey guys, Travis Woo here with a little deck tech slash quick report on this red-black aggressive deck that I drafted day two at Pro Tour Born in the Gods. The draft went very well. As you can see, I only have a couple cards not in my colors, so I had tons of options. I think I drafted very well. I think that I played well given the options. I think that I built definitely wrong, and I didn't have time or notice until when the tournament was over. When the tournament's going, there's so much going on, it's hard to make adjustments in between rounds, I feel. Maybe I'm wrong about that, but that's the way that I felt. Anyways, how the draft went is, in my first pick, the cards that stood out to me were Fearsome Temper and Tromocratus. Tromocratus being the 7-mana 8-8. Fearsome Temper being a weird one to first pick, but I figured Tromocratus would maybe even table if I really wanted to go that route. Wasn't sure that I wanted to build around the 7-mana 8-8 hexproof, which maybe I should have, but I think Fearsome Temper is a pretty strong card. And as you can see from the draft before, I really wanted to get the pack one red hookup if possible. Reason Temper is just super aggressive with Kragma Butcher. It gets your two drops through and offers some evasion. I mean, it can be vulnerable and leave you vulnerable to bounce in the same way Feral Invocation can. But for red, I think this is a pretty strong effect, and it worked out pretty well. As second pick, I was passed a Bolt of Kuranos, which I took, clearly. And then the third pack had a Kragma Butcher. I really, really, really like Kragma Butcher. He's just really big. Play him turn three if you can clear the way or attack and not lose him. Untapping with a 4-3. Keep untapping with 4-3 is just pretty spicy. I like this a lot more than the Minotaur Skull Cleaver. He even has 3 toughness. So I got past that. And then I got past another Skull Cleaver, and at this point I'm really not caring about other colors. I'm like, these are solid. This is a solid start to any draft, right? These four. Get past a Searing Blood, which definitely to me is a signal that the people upstream don't want to be heavy red. Not that this card is incredibly good. It's similar to Phyreka's Cure, but it's more aggressive. Can do 3 instead of gaining 2, but with what I had, it seemed great. From there, my 6th pick, I had a choice between a Fellhide Brawler, which is a 2-mana 2-2, or an Oresco Sun Guide. I'd like to be red-white over red-black if possible, or just white in general. Sun Guide is very good, like Traveling Philosopher is playable, Fellhide Brawler is playable. Oresco Sun Guide is much better than those cards, so it's very good, and I wanted to be white. However, I ended up maybe short a 2-drop, not having the Brawler. Not really, but I picked this, and then from there, red dried up for a little bit. Got a lot of black in the back end of the pack, the black being nothing in my main. Archetype of Insanity, Shrike Harpy, Eye Gouge, Servant all came around late, and somehow in my sideboard. This shouldn't be in the main. We'll get back to why these are in the board and whether they should have been in the main. But black's coming around late. Doesn't mean I necessarily want to be black, though. Second pack, I open the Lightning Strike. So I have the Lightning Strike, the Bolt, 2 Butchers, Fearsome Temper, Searing Blood. I'm like, alright, need some 2-drops. Oh yeah, I got Impetuous Sun Chasers late, which I don't like very much, but they fly in the red, which is a rare effect, so it can be okay. Second pick was a really interesting pack. I took a Bronze Sable, not very strong, but red doesn't have the most 2s. With the 3s that I had, I felt like I won as many 2s as possible. I felt that the best card in there, and maybe there's stuff that I missed, other than it was a Baleful Eidolon. Baleful Eidolon being definitely better, if I'm black with these black cards, but I wasn't sold that I was going to be black. I wanted to see what the table was going to pass me this pack, and Sable is fine. So after what happened, the Eidolon would have been way better. However, that doesn't necessarily mean that the Sable was an incorrect pack, as if I had kept my options open until the next pick, where I took an Ordeal, black Ordeal. I was like, all right, Ordeal goes well with two drops. It goes well with the Butcher. If I can clear with the Bolt, if I can use it with the Fearsome Temper, it can be good. Got past another Ordeal. And then basically what happened from there, now that I was in black, is red and black just flowed. I never missed a pick on color almost. I could have hate drafted things, I suppose, but I prefer to have more options for myself, and I didn't feel I feel there weren't points where I was like, definitely should hate draft this card, I can't beat it or anything like that. As for other interesting picks, I saw a couple Dragon Mantles, which I would have liked, but I felt that I needed creatures because I had a lot of good spells, because I ended up with the three Ordeals. I got a Boon late. I got a table to Flesh Mad Steed, which was great. I picked Arena Athlete over Baleful Eidolon. I thought this card was pretty solid target for Cavern Lampads or Erebos's Emissaries. I just, I had a good monstrous guy. Although in retrospect, I would have liked the second Baleful Eidolon even. Of the Cerberuses, which work well with the Ordeals and the Cavern Lampads and the Erebos's Emissary, and I have the Titan Strength, and this is just seems like even now it seems like it seems like a solid deck. Like, it's very aggressive. It can curve out. It has decent removal. It has a lot of finishing punch. I got Hammer of Purphoros Crazy Light in pack 3. So this is a deck that can operate on two lands for a while. And has good mana sinks if I get flooded too. I have a great monstrous, three good bestow, good finishing bestow, hammer. So I was like, this is a great deck. What ended up first, I'll get to the build second, but as for the, I don't know that building better would have done too much. The third round, I played against the 5C Chromanticore Brew, which anything was going to beat, I feel like, sorry, opponent. But that was how that went. The first match, I got crushed by Quick Giant Reverent Hunter both games. I had mana problems. I kept getting Mountain and only Swamps, having built 10-7. I missed my third land drop in one of those two games. Giant Reverent Hunter early, run under a bus. Didn't have the Eidolons in my deck. If I had taken Eidolons here, then I might have been able to win, and had a different deck perhaps. So that was the first round. The second round, I again had mana problems. This time I flooded really heavily without drawing any of these. So I don't know that changing would have been too much, but if I had had more of these strong black cards instead of the other weak red cards, maybe I could have survived for longer and drawn into these and gotten to a third game and maybe won. Given that, yeah, this guy also had early. I faced early Reverent both games in the first match. Second match, faced early Master of Waves both games too, which caused me a lot of problems, being that almost all of my creatures are red. So I had boarded in some black cards to switch things up. Yeah, so basically let's go ahead and look at the deck that I think that I should have built instead, looking back on it. Going more controlling, taking advantage of these of the Gray Merchant and the good black cards I have. Like, I was thinking that I was needed to run more swamps than mountains, on account of Bolt of Kuranos, Searing Blood, and then liking the Cerberuses, which are okay. I still like them a bit. I mean, I have the two Lampads, and that is actually a pretty sick combo. I have the Emissary, and I have other tricks in the Ordeal. So once we get in these black cards, we can get out some of the weaker two drops. I just added a lot of black. We're going to move up the curve. We're going to move to heavy black. We're going to cut these. We can maybe still run Searing Blood. We'll come back to that. We don't necessarily need that anymore. We're going to go light on Ordeals. Just because... what if we go light on... the Raider? I'm not sure how this is going to work exactly. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 24, something like that. Maybe cut Titan Strength and go heavier, go 9, 8, black, red. There's also a couple Farrica's Cures in the draft that I passed on, and maybe I could have those. But something like this looks way better to me because we still have the big punch of the Butchers. And the Fearsome Temper, and still have the Red Burn, and still have two drops, and we still have these six drops, but we just have more powerful magic cards. Again, I don't know if this would have helped me. This would have helped me in the Flood games, not in the Screw games, but, I mean, it goes to show how complex magic is that you can... I felt that I drafted generally pretty awesome. I missed out on a few good cards, but I... did it to keep options open, I felt. Maybe, given more information, I would have done things differently. But, I mean, I felt that I drafted pretty well. And I felt that I played decently with the options given. But I felt that I built wrong, too. So there's so much going on with Magic. So this was my day two draft deck.